Trading at the Philippine Stock Exchange officially kicked off this Thursday. Today's opening numbers at 65.82, actually 5 minutes after trade. We're now up about 0.3% or 0.4% at 65.96. And with the PSE main index up by over, 0.4%, that is, value so far is at 162 billion pesos, with advancers and decliners at 36 to 29. Now, what should investors do next, especially amid geopolitical challenges and worries on the Fed's next moves? To give us guidance for this week, we have with us Katrina J. Dizon from AIA Investment Management and Trust Corporation for a conversation on bonds and even fixed income instruments. Welcome to the program, Jay.
Morning. Hi, Stanley. Thank you for having me.
It's good to have you here. Now, we're now resigned to the fact that the Banco Central, or even the Federal Reserve, is in no hurry really to temper those interest rates. This has affected investor appetite in risky assets. What about fixed income and bonds? Are you seeing yields trending up higher in a high interest rate environment? Possibly
a prolonged one. Stanley.
Yeah.
So after so much anticipation for a policy, for policy rate cuts at the start of the year, strong data out of the U.S. seems to have stumped or stalled the disinflation, scenario for now. So here we go again. We have to reset our expectations. And so I think with policy cuts stalled or pushed back to late 2024 or even possibly to 2025, the view for high for longer interest rates is now back on the table.
All right. Now, on the supply side, Jay, seeing corporates, disheartened by prohibitive borrowing rates, they may be looking for other ways to raise capital in lieu of, regular bank lending. Are you seeing more companies now raising funds via bonds?
It's very interesting, despite the recent uptick in rates, I still think tapping the bond market is still a viable option for companies. Uh-huh. In fact, we're seeing a number of issuers right now. There's a healthy pipeline. Mm-hmm. Well, I know that it's a costlier route for issuers to do this, but it gives them a chance to raise funding with a diverse investor base, right? So I think it's not the current interest environment is not a showstopper given prospects of growth for these companies as well.
Okay, now Jay, without many options, you're saying currently within the fixed income space, what must investors consider now before stocking up on those instruments? And maybe tell us what kind of risk appetite must one have these days when looking into bonds versus equities, for instance?
Okay. Yeah, thank you. Well, we all know that risk drives returns, right? Investors should be aware of their risk-taking capacity. How long can they invest in bonds? What's the horizon or tenor that they're comfortable to lock their money in, right? While the prospect of capital growth is always there when you sell the bonds at a higher price, the probability of losses when you sell it is also there. So investors just have to be aware of these risks. If I can't sell this bond, if I need money, will I have other sources? So diversification is also key, aside from being aware of your risk appetite.
All right, there's a bit of conflict there because, when you talk about tenors, companies that issued them would want longer tenors, but investors might prefer much shorter timelines. What yield ranges and tenors would you think is best, given investors may not want to be locked in longer?
Well, again, it goes back to the investor's risk appetite. No? If I look at the yield curve right now, even if we've seen yields to steepen, meaning the 2 and the 10-year differential has actually widened a lot since the recent move in interest rates. We still see value in the belly, meaning the 5 to 7 years, and even at the 10 years at closer to 7%, right?
Okay.
So, it all boils down to how investors are able to gap their investment requirements with these outlets that we have, So, and usually primary issuances will have different tranches for investors to get into. There will be a 3, 5, 7, and even a 10 year.
Okay, on the flip side, of course, is company performance. You know, we have persisting headwinds from global economic and geopolitical challenges. This may temper growth of many businesses, a risk on the part of investors, in a way. Now, what do you advise your clients what to consider when shopping for fixed income, as this is not just about yields or tenors now, but really it's about performance and returns?
But geopolitical risks and even other kinds of risks, black swan, will always be present, right? So again, we've stressed that risk drives returns, but more importantly, investors should be looking at long-term investing, meaning it's time in the market than timing the market that's more important, right? So with the recent move in rates, I think it's a good opportunity to lather in, right? We've always stressed on cost averaging their investment holdings, not locking in to all your eggs in just one basket, right? Diversifying through, different tenors, different securities, and different issuers. And you get to be picky at that, right? In terms of which one has which one is more stable and have more capacity as well.
Okay, and speaking of diversifying that basket, looking at the pandemic years up to now, I'm wondering, Jay, if the portfolios at AIA have changed. Did you see growing interest in preference for fixed income bonds and treasury notes being the choice when it comes to capital preservation as compared to maybe stocks or even currencies?
Well, AIA is actually a long-term investor. We were a staunch advocate of long-term investing and ESG investments as well. Having said that, we have a healthy profile or strategic mix of assets in our investment portfolio, whether it be bonds, stocks, even real estate investments, whether it be private or corp or public, fixed income, or even funds, right? So we Since the pandemic, we've actually been more dynamic in terms of our allocation. We tweak our tactical allocation regularly in order to keep up with, the market trends. Having said that, we welcome the high interest rate environment to source and issue a combination of guaranteed products for our policyholders. And over the past 2 years, we've issued funds that either have dynamic asset allocation and even a fund that has a regular dividend payout. So the investment acumen has not changed.
Okay. Now, Jay, on another topic, in line with the Fund Managers Association of the Philippines' anniversary, we've been speaking with members on this show for all the week, and all of them have bannered gains in terms of, professionalizing the investment management landscape in the country. Now, what are the current activities at FMAP that you're excited about?
Thank you for bringing that up, Stanley. I know that my board trustees have already tackled on our partnership with the IFC on the recently ESG recently launched ESG workshops. So what's next? We've partnered up with the PSE. There's a PSE Star Investor Day that's
Right, it's upcoming.
going to be
Okay.
held, on May 15 and 16,
All right.
where FMAP members, equity analysts, will be moderating forums with different companies.
Okay.
So
Now,
that's one.
that's
And a
one.
lot more in the pipeline.
Yeah, and speaking of, a lot more and maybe in the pipeline, these days government is talking a lot about improving, financial inclusion numbers. And aside from, getting the unbanked into the financial system, the goal also includes encouraging more Filipinos to invest and grow their money. Do you have activities at FMAP, whether current or in the future, in the pipeline to support this?
Sure. Actually, FMAP is also an advocate of financial literacy, right? And we've always believed in making sure that we cover or we disseminate investor information to the public. We've held seminars publicly, as well as We've partnered with educational institutions like QP, where we actually sponsor scholarships, and we even sponsor theses, you know, in terms of topics about deepening the capital market. And we provide allowances, stipend for these students. So we want to hit it at the fundamental side of things, basically shoring up on investor education and sharing it to the public.
All right, pretty exciting times there. Jay Dison, thank you so much. This has been a good conversation. Good luck with FMAP, and have a great day.
Thank you, Stanley.
Thank you.